Hello again, Chris White from Perrycroft Bees. Just thought I'd do this little video in case you were wondering what beekeepers get up to in the winter time. Well, one thing they do is they make up frames for next year. And I'm just going to show you how you make up a British Standard National super frame. Okay, just get bits ready. Two of those. Sorry. Two of those and a top bar, two chopsticks, two side bars. Now I like to glue and nail mine because I want my frames to last as long as possible, and also it means they stand up better to the cleaning and repair work which has to go on till next day. Okay, so I actually put the glue on first. I'll put it on the two corners of the top bar. Hope you can see this, and then I put the side frames in. Make sure that the slot obviously is facing inwards. These frames are Hoffman self-spacing. As you can see, they're tapered at the bottom, but this space here gives you the correct bee space. Stick that in there. I don't glue the top bars because when I'm cleaning, I'd like to get them out. It helps with repair, so I just nail these in. I make sure the nails go in down this way because then I can prise them out at a later date. If you nail them crossways, you've got to pull the nail out before you can actually release the bar. So I'm going to start hitting with a hammer now, but hopefully that won't make the camera jar too much. So I've constructed it. It's without nails, and now I'm just going to nail it in. So, as you can see, these little gimp nails. I do it all by hand, and I think nailing is a lot better than actually using a staple gun. Staple guns are pretty brutal; they tend to damage the wood, and also you can't get the staples out too easily afterwards. So. Sometimes it's much better to actually do something by hand and make a nice proper handmade job. Nails in. So one in each corner. This frame is upside down. These are the bottom bars. Some people have a different way of loading them. This is the way I do it. Which I've made many of them, and this seems to be the best for the way I do it. So those are batches we put in. I will now nail crossways into the top bar because I don't actually take that out and it's been glued now, so that should keep it for a long period of time. So I've nailed this in. These frames have been manufactured by machine. I couldn't make these as good myself, and so when you actually make them, it generally comes out nice and square because all of the angles have been cut precisely. All that remains now is to put the wax foundation in, and as you can see, there's a pre-cut bar here, hopefully. And I'm just going to run a knife through there and prise that out, just like a chopstick. That comes out, and that's going to be nailed back in once the foundation has been put in. So then place the frame upside down again. I'm just going to get the foundation. This is wired foundation. Hopefully you can see the wiring in it. It's called worker cell because the spacing between these indents, the starter cells, are for workers. If it was for drones, they're slightly bigger and the spacing would be wider. As the colony of bees is mostly workers, these are the ones we're going to use the most of. It's been pre-cut to the right size since it's bought as British Standard National Deep. And what I do is, if you look at them, they always end up with a slightly larger hoop at one end. And I always push that one down, with the frame upside down, through the slot. And you see it goes through quite easily. Don't force it. If you've made the frame a little tight around here, you may have to trim it with a pair of scissors. Okay, so I let it come down, and if you look where the piece of wood has been removed, I bend the, I'm doing this to show you, I bend the these hoops at right angles, because then that will help this foundation stay in once it's been inverted in the hive. As you can see, it will just pop out otherwise. So I push that down like that, and as you can see, the hoops are now nice and horizontal. And then take this frame, place it in, and I use two nails because I don't see why you need to put any more in. I nail them at a slight angle, but as in a slight angle that way, but generally straight in that way. And this enables me to get this piece of wood back out again when I come to clean the frames. I'll just show you the reverse of what I would do. A hive tool. This was now drawn out. I can get the hive tool in here. Maybe you can see this, and then I can prise that back out quite easily. Here is a frame completed. I might say one of hundreds which commercial beekeepers will be making in the winter time. I just thought I'd just share that simple building with you. Just got another probably 500 to go before the spring. If you like these videos, please please tick the subscribe button to www.perrycroftbees.co.uk is my email address. And I shall be publishing some more shortly. Thank you.